Have you ever wondered how a volcano comes to be? It's a fascinating journey that starts miles below the Earth's surface, in a place where intense heat and pressure coalesce to create something truly powerful. Let's dive beneath the Earth's crust, to the molten core where our journey begins. Here, the temperature can reach an astounding 9,000 degrees Fahrenheit. This intense heat causes rocks to melt into a thick, viscous substance we know as magma. But magma doesn't like to stay put. It's lighter than the surrounding rock, so it starts to rise, pushing its way up through the Earth's crust. Now, the Earth's crust isn't one solid piece. It's like a giant jigsaw puzzle made up of large pieces called tectonic plates. These plates are constantly on the move, albeit at a pace slower than a snail's crawl. But even at this glacial pace, they have a profound impact on the Earth's topography. When these plates collide, things really start to get interesting. One plate may be forced beneath another in a process called subduction. This adds more heat and pressure to the mix, causing even more magma to form. And when this magma finds a weak spot in the Earth's crust, it pushes its way to the surface, forming a volcano. But not all volcanoes are born from these tectonic collisions. Some form in the middle of tectonic plates, over hotspots. These are areas where magma rises directly from the Earth's mantle, creating a chain of volcanoes as the tectonic plate shifts over time. So, whether it's a clash of tectonic titans or a mantle hotspot, the birth of a volcano is a testament to the dynamic, ever-changing nature of our planet. It's a process that takes thousands, even millions of years, unfolding beneath our feet in the fiery depths of the Earth. And so, in the depths of the Earth, a volcano begins its journey. Now that we know how a volcano is born, let's delve into its structure. Imagine a volcano as a grand theater, with each part playing a crucial role in the dramatic performance of an eruption. The first component of this natural spectacle is the magma chamber. This is the backstage area, deep beneath the Earth's surface, where molten rock known as magma accumulates. The size of these chambers can vary, but they're all essentially pressure cookers, building up heat and gas until they're ready to burst. Next, we have the conduit or pipe, the main pathway from the magma chamber to the surface. Picture this as the curtains that separate our backstage from the audience. When the pressure in the magma chamber becomes too great, it's showtime. The magma forces its way up through the conduit, carrying with it fragments of rock and gas. Now we come to the vent, the star of our show. This is the opening in the Earth's surface through which the magma escapes. Vents can be on the side of a volcano, creating side blasts, or they can be at the top, creating those classic sky-high eruptions we often envision when thinking about volcanoes. Last but not least, we have the crater, the aftermath of the magma's grand entrance. This is the bowl-shaped depression at the top of the volcano. After an eruption, the crater can be left filled with lava, or it might become a lake if rainwater or groundwater fills it up. Each of these components, the magma chamber, conduit, vent, and crater, work in harmony to create the breathtaking and terrifying spectacle that is a volcanic eruption. They are all interconnected, each playing a vital role in the build-up, eruption, and aftermath. The volcano, a marvel of nature, stands ready for its explosive performance. So, always remember, when you see a volcano, you're not just looking at a mountain, but a complex and dynamic system, a theater of nature's most dramatic performance. But what triggers an eruption, setting this geological time bomb off? Well, it all starts miles beneath the Earth's surface, in a region called the mantle. The mantle is a layer of hot, molten rock, known as magma. This magma is under an immense amount of pressure, caused by the weight of the overlying rock and the heat from the Earth's core. As the mantle's temperature increases, the pressure within the magma also rises. This heat and pressure create a volatile environment, a bit like a pressure cooker on a stove. But instead of a tasty meal, this pressure cooker is chock full of molten rock and various gases. Now, when the magma's pressure becomes too great to be contained by the overlying rock, something's got to give. The magma begins to rise, forcing its way through any weaknesses in the rock above, creating what we call a magma chamber closer to the Earth's surface. This magma chamber fills up over time, with the pressure continually building. It's a bit like blowing up a balloon. The more you blow, the thinner the balloon's walls become, and the closer it gets to bursting. As the magma chamber expands, the pressure within the chamber also increases. The magma, now a frothing mixture of molten rock and gas, has become a ticking time bomb waiting for just the right moment to explode. But what's the final straw that breaks the camel's back? It's usually an external factor, like an earthquake or a change in the Earth's crust. These events can cause the pressure in the magma chamber to suddenly increase, or the chamber's walls to weaken, leading to an explosive release of the magma. This explosive release is what we see on the surface as a volcanic eruption. The magma, now called lava, bursts forth from the Earth's crust, accompanied by clouds of ash and gas. The eruption can be explosive, like a firework, or gentle, like an overflowing pot, depending on the magma's composition. The stage is set, the pressure is high, and the volcano finally erupts. And the world witnesses the awe-inspiring and often devastating power of Mother Nature. The eruption is a spectacle, but what happens when it meets human civilization? The raw power of volcanic eruptions can have a colossal impact on both the environment and human communities. Imagine a force so intense that it can wipe out entire cities, alter landscapes, and even change the course of history. That's the devastating reality of volcanic eruptions. One of the most significant impacts of a volcanic eruption is the emission of ash and gas into the Earth's atmosphere. This ash can blanket the sky, causing temperatures to plummet, and leading to what's known as a volcanic winter. This cataclysmic event is not just a theory. It happened over 70,000 years ago when the super eruption at Lake Toba in Indonesia caused a global volcanic winter that lasted for up to a decade. Volcanic eruptions also have a profound impact on human communities. The eruption of Mount Vesuvius in 79 AD buried the Roman cities of Pompeii and Herculaneum under meters of ash and pumice, preserving them in time, but at the cost of thousands of lives. Fast forward to the modern era, the eruption of Mount St. Helens in 1980 erupted with a force equivalent to 500 Hiroshima bombs, causing 57 fatalities and inflicting extensive damage to homes and infrastructure. And let's not forget the environmental consequences. The lava and pyroclastic flows from eruptions can wipe out entire ecosystems, causing loss of habitat and threatening biodiversity. The gases released during eruptions, such as sulfur dioxide, can also contribute to acid rain and global warming. However, it's essential to remember that not all eruptions lead to such widespread devastation. Some eruptions can have beneficial effects, like creating new land, enriching soils, and providing geothermal energy. But when nature unleashes its full fury in the form of a volcanic eruption, the results can be catastrophic. It's a stark reminder of the power and unpredictability of our planet. Volcanic eruptions, while fascinating, can bring about widespread destruction. As we coexist with these fiery giants, how do we prepare for their wrath? Living alongside volcanoes, while daunting, is a reality for many communities worldwide. It's a game of resilience and preparedness, of understanding the Earth's rhythms and respecting its raw elemental power. But how exactly do these communities prepare for the potential fury of a volcanic eruption? The first step is harnessing the power of science. Modern technology allows us to monitor volcanoes closely, using seismic activity detectors and gas sensors to pick up on any changes that could indicate an impending eruption. These early warning systems are crucial, providing a precious window of time for communities to react and prepare. However, technology alone isn't enough. It's equally important to have robust evacuation plans in place. These plans must be comprehensive and well-practiced, covering everything from identifying safe evacuation routes to ensuring everyone in the community knows what to do in the event of an eruption. Regular drills and public awareness campaigns are key to keeping everyone informed and ready to act swiftly when needed. Living with volcanoes also means adapting to the landscape, both literally and figuratively. Building designs, for instance, often need to consider the potential for volcanic ashfall, which can be heavy enough to collapse roofs. Farming practices, too, may need to adapt to the rich but potentially volatile soils that volcanoes produce. But perhaps the most important part of living with volcanoes is fostering a deep respect for these powerful natural phenomena. They are a reminder of the Earth's dynamism, of its ability to create and destroy, often in the same breath. Living in their shadow is a humbling experience, a testament to the resilience of the human spirit, and a constant reminder of our place in the natural world. In the end, living with volcanoes is about more than just survival. It's about understanding, adapting, and thriving in a world that's constantly changing. constantly challenging us to grow and evolve. Preparation is key when living in the shadow of a volcano. So, how many of these fiery giants are currently active around the world? Well, it's a moving target, but at any given time, there are approximately 1,500 active volcanoes on our planet. These include both those on land and under the sea. The majority of these are located along the Pacific Ring of Fire, a major area in the basin of the Pacific Ocean where a large number of earthquakes and volcanic eruptions occur. But they're not just confined to this region. From the snow-covered peaks of Mount Etna in Italy, to the smoky calderas of Yellowstone in the United States, from the fiery fissures of Kilauea in Hawaii, to the ash-spewing cone of Mount Fuji in Japan, active volcanoes dot our global landscape, each with its unique character and potential for destruction. As we speak, the Earth's fiery giants continue their age-old dance,